Yeah.
Hi everybody, welcome to the video. My name is Owen Fox from higherselfherbs.com, and today I want to share with you my favourite herbs at the moment, and also what I take every day as a staple. And my intention for this video is to help make you and your life happier and healthier and more fun, more exciting, basically, because I used to be really wrecked. My body was wrecked and sick, and now I have a very happy, healthy, prosperous life, and that's what I want for you too. So I'll tell you today, right now, my favorite herbs that I love to take are cordyceps. This isn't in any particular order, by the way. So cordyceps, it's an amazing medicinal mushroom. It's like fantastic for energy, lungs, and your immune system. It really gives me a lot of energy. I love taking with just simply like take 1 teaspoon of the extract powder, instant tea, 10 to 12, 13% concentrate, like 10 times more powerful than just the powder. It's already extracted. You can just pour hot water in as an instant tea. So I love to take this as a tea. It tastes really nice and it smells good too. So cordyceps. I also love, my new most favorite one lately is Siberian ginseng. I've learned and studied so much about like Siberian ginseng in the past, and I used to take a tiny bit when I was small. My brother takes it. But Siberian ginseng is a really phenomenal herb, like rhodiola, which is another one of my favorites. It's great for physical, mental, and emotional, body, mind, spirit. It's fantastic, like they're basically fantastic for energy, endurance, stamina, exercise, sport, but also for people like with anxiety, like feeling down, or even helps with depression, just boosting your spirits and having a better mood in life, which is super healthy, like super important to be happier in life and to combat stress. Both of those two, rhodiola and Siberian ginseng, are like incredible, two of the world's most powerful adaptogens. So adaptogens help you to combat stress, to deal with physical like stress, chemicals, toxins, drugs, environmental pollutants, overall mental and emotional stress from the busy, hectic life we live in these days. It's full of challenges on this earth that we live in at this time period. So really good for overall coping and managing and adapting. So what else? Every day these days, as my staples, is definitely Rejuvenate formula, which includes, Rejuvenate's the biggest seller on my website. Rejuvenate has like Hoshiwu as its main ingredient, which is great for like hair color and just generally hair health, and some people even say like regrowing hair, that's what it's most famous for. So Hoshiwu. Then it has also Shizandra as the second one in the blend. Shizandra is a triple treasured herb, which is great for basically works on all like body, mind, spirit, and also all 12 meridian systems and all 5 organ systems in the Chinese medical terminology. So that basically speaking every organ and every energy channel in our body. So I don't personally find Shizandra as powerful as rhodiola or Siberian ginseng in terms of its power of the body, mind, spirit, but it's more subtle but all round effect on all of the organs and different body parts. Siberian ginseng and rhodiola would give more energy, that's what I've noticed, and probably better mood too. Another one of my favourites that I haven't been taking lately is gynostemma, which is brilliant, another adaptogen. Has 100 or so saponins, whereas ginseng only has around 36. Gynostemma is found because like everyone living in that part of Asia, the small part in China, they all were living very old and healthy and sickness free. So gynostemma is another awesome herb that I generally recommend, and I want to personally take more of every day if possible, which is possible. All I need to do is do it. Rejuvenate has like a lot of other ones. It has like Hoshu, Shizandra, other yin jing herbs such as dendrobium, ligustrum, prepared romania, all very, very, very famous, like nourishing, replenishing, adrenal boosting herbs, which is great for stress and not being tired, not being exhausted, not being fatigued, and having more energy. So another one I'd recommend is that I love to take is the strength formula. Really good for your hormones, giving it a boost, giving it a shot of more like testosterone, more passion, drive, enthusiasm, get-go, focus, and being more grounded and physically manifesting your life. So strength has 3 qi herbs in it as the main 3, and maybe three or four yang jing herbs, like testosterone, male, get-go, manifest, focus, be passionate. not just about like libido and the bedroom passion, but just general passion of fire and gecko and life. So they're the yang jing herbs. Rejuvenate is yin jing, which is the opposite, replenishing and nourishing and restoring and building up like feminine herbs like yin. Yang is the masculine herbs. So rejuvenate and hoshu, for example, prepared mania, they're all the yin jing, and strength is the yang jing. So it's good to take a yin jing with a yang, the yang jing formula, to replenish what you're using up. But it's really nice. Like, I know some people who say like their favorite formula is to take with them when they're traveling or any day is the strength formula, because it gives them a boost and an energy boost, because it has three chi herbs of astragalus, codonopsis, and white atracolodes, which are like spleen, digestive strength, digestive health, energy, chi herbs. Really good. So that's always nice to have every day, or at least me, I don't take it every day, but take it most fair few days of the week. But what I always take religiously is to rejuvenate, because I'm rebuilding my body and my adrenals from being shot. If you have chronic fatigue syndrome or overall tiredness or exhaustion, definitely take the rejuvenate. It's like so important. Or if you don't want to take the rejuvenate, take a couple of yin jing herbs that are contained in rejuvenate if you feel like taking them separately. And as I said already, I really love cordyceps, brilliant for energy. I love Siberian ginseng, brilliant for energy and also generally like mood and anti-fatigue and mood booster. And of course there's rhodiola. I personally am not taking too much rhodiola these days, but I think it's phenomenal, but I'm taking Siberian ginseng instead. Very similar in many ways, to be honest, very, very powerful roots. So what else do I love to take every day? I told you basically what I took today, for example, is I took a rejuvenate, cordyceps tea, I'm going in the morning. I also take MSM, which you can see all these links below, okay, because some of these I don't sell on my website, and a lot of them I do. But the ones I don't, I have links, which you can find the best value ones on the internet. For example, the MSM that I get, which I think is fantastic. I used to buy a 500 gram pack, but then I found a 1 kilogram pack, double, for just like an extra few dollars only. So almost like half price. Same stuff exactly. So yeah, you can have a look at the links below for all of these things, okay? So I took turmeric also, because turmeric is truly a super herb spice. It's anti-cancerous and anti-tumor. Turmeric is like very antioxidant too. Turmeric and chaga, I used to make a wild green superfood medicinal formula made from wild greens that I picked myself, but then it was just so much work, and then the spring ended and I'm out of stock for a long time. But at the time I was thinking the two herbs that I really would love to add to it if it wasn't just for the wild green superfood medicines would be chaga and turmeric, because they're so potent anti-inflammatories, anti-cancerous and anti-tumor, like really, 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 really good. So chaga is another massive beloved favorite herb of mine also. Super medicinal mushroom, the king of medicinal mushrooms. It's so good, it's called the king of medicinal mushrooms. It's David Wolf's favorite mushroom. He's a crazy herbalist and health enthusiast for like decades. He's written an entire book on chaga, and it's his favorite mushroom, and I know why. It's super, especially for people who have either been sick or who live in a dirty environment or have had a non-optimal diet for a long time. Chaga is a phenomenal triple treasured herb, like shen, qi, and jing. So, hey man, just making a video, how's it going? Doesn't matter, I can edit this out. Maybe I'll just leave it here, actually. No buttons. Yeah. So, I don't... These days I haven't been taking chaga every day, but what I would take every day is definitely rejuvenate or yin jing for everybody. Highly suggest that. And turmeric is just brilliant. I have it on in my shop where you can get it, just organic turmeric other places, but the one I have in my shop is already extracted, so you don't have to necessarily extract it yourself, or you can just buy the fresh turmeric also and juice it or whatever. So, what else do I take every day? I take the Super Greens formula. Super Greens is phenomenal. It has 27 tonic herbs and superfoods in it, including chaga, including cordyceps, including shiitake and mitake, and marine phytoplankton and barley grass juice powder, not just the powder. It has dandelion leaf, nettle leaf powder, not the juice. It has an udder juice, it has chlorella, it's All of these have been everything in my shop has been independently tested by different companies for purity and potency. So it's clean from toxins and pesticides. It's been tested and stuff. Also, all of my herbal extracts are like 10 to 1 or maybe 12 to 1 concentrates. And extracts absorb really quickly within 20 minutes into the system, so you get the benefits. They're really potent. All you need to do is pour hot water on the extracts, or warm water, or cold water, or add to a juice, or even a cup of smoothie. But generally, not taking with too much fiber or food, just generally with like water or juice. The super green has like green in it, so you don't pour hot water on that because you don't want to interfere with the greens. But the other stuff like roots, it's good to extract them, or the medicinal mushrooms. Wall, and you have to break down the wall to get the nutrients and the medicine, so that's why extracts are so handy. So I used to be sick, as I said, and taking a therapeutic dosage of these herbs and superfoods, not a maintenance. There's a difference between a maintenance dosage and a therapeutic means you have to take much more, and it really, you need to, like, if you've been an injured or sick body, to really dump in a lot of nutrition and cleanse at the same time. I'd highly recommend at the same time to heal the body. And then there's also, of course, water fasting, but that's difficult for a lot of people. It's tricky, it can be dangerous to do it on your own. Obviously, I love water fasting, but I haven't really delved too deeply into that at the moment. I'm just rebuilding and strengthening my body extremely effectively by taking herbs and superfoods and a pretty balanced life holistically, and also a pretty good diet, improving my diet little by little too. Like, listening to my body is my number one piece of advice regarding health and diet, and making sure you get enough energy, or just try to listen to your needs physically, mentally, and emotionally. You know, we all have social, spiritual, like different types of needs, creative needs, expression, needs to express ourselves, need to contribute to society, to be of service, to feel worthwhile, to feel valuable. Like, there's a lot of things to help and happiness in life. You know, health of body, health of mind, health of spirit, and happy and emotional health too. So I'll put a video here about tips for maybe depression or feeling down and just getting boosted in life. But overall, this video is just like telling you about my daily herb regimen. I usually take herbs like at least twice a day, a big whole load of them. So I take like one big teaspoon of super greens in the morning. I take the Rejuvenate, I take MSM, I take often I add in cordyceps or rhodiola to the powder as well. I often take cordyceps on its own as a hot tea. Maca is another one of my favourite herbs. Top of the list, up to the top two or three, top two even. Maca is a sensational herb. The reason why maca stands out as being very special and important is because, unlike all the other herbs I mentioned, it's amazing for every single one of your hormonal system, all of your glands, of your endocrine gland system. So like, maca is another one I'd highly recommend, especially for women, but even especially for men too. It's very good for like menses, perimenopause, menopause. It's good for your thyroid, it's good for your adrenal glands, it's good for your thymus, it's good for your male hormonal health, and it's good for female hormonal health, like their sexual glands too, you know. It's basically, it's good for your pituitary, you're probably good for your pineal. Hormones are extremely important in the body. If they are off, everything's going to be not working properly. Hormones are like the governors, and the organs are like people in the town. So the hormones are like what governs and tells
people in the town what to do. So if your hormones are off, that's bad. And I don't know, I think a lot of people have hormonal interference because of all the pollutants and pesticides and factory farmed milk and dairy they're taking in the world. It messes up with your hormones.
Children are like going into puberty prematurely, which is not good. That's not good at all. Like, longevity is associated with how slowly you enter puberty. So getting into puberty, like, you know, too early is just not good. It's unnatural. It's like too much hormonal disruptors. People are losing their sex drive and libido. I have a section for like sex drive and libido. That they're yang jing herbs. I have the most powerful yang jing, like, testosterone boosting herb in the world. It's called Fancatalee. It's potent, so you don't think it's by the way. But you really just want to like take maca. I recommend maca for everybody. Maca, Rejuvenate. Maca and Rejuvenate. And then have fun with all the other ones too. Boost your energy in life, like Siberian ginseng or rhodiola or strength formula, like, so good. Cordyceps. But yeah, I take maca every day religiously. It's something that I don't want to do without, the same as the rejuvenate formula, which is a yin jing herb formula, and the super greens. You want to take a good formula like greens every day, in my opinion, generally speaking. And overall, you also want to cleanse your body sometimes for definite, like, or even as an ongoing, constant daily thing, by taking a lot of fruits. I have a cleanse formula, which is really good for cleansing and cleansing and strengthening the liver, and also cleansing and building the blood. Rejuvenate is also builds the blood. Maca, rejuvenate, and strength, they're all libido enhancing. They all like enhance your libido. And your fertility, so they enhance your fertility, which is always good to be more fertile, like, you know, grow better. So yeah, maca also gives you energy, stamina, endurance, boosts your mood, it boosts your libido. Maca invigorates you. It's like, maca is sensational. I love maca. It's not just for women, it just happens to be brilliant for women as well as men. Highly recommend maca. So anyway, that's more or less what I take. I take it twice a day. At least, sometimes take it three times. Extremely rarely, I only take one big drink. I just usually take everything with like water, room temperature water. But like I said, sometimes it's nice to take the herbs individually, like, and actually taste them. I don't care as much as taste as I do for results. I'm like rebuilding my body and my life after being out of the game in my 20s. All in my 20s, I was like sick. Before the age of 20, I was like bursting with energy. Then I blew it all up. I blew myself out, you know, like I burst my bubble. So from all in my 20s and even a little bit after that, I was sort of not really in the game physically properly. So I'm focused on getting the results of replenishment and rejuvenation and having a better life together. More like in my 20s, my sex drive was also really low, as I've really wrecked my, I stressed the hell out of my hormonal system, my adrenals. My digestive system went down totally as well. I was so tired. I used to sleeping in the afternoon from doing nothing almost. So these days I'm much more vigorous, way better manifester, much happier and more healthy, more physically active. I'm cycling for ages, do loads of stuff. Like I've much more like libido and sexually turn on again, like, which is like you want to be like that in your 20s and 30s or even 40s and 50s even. Sex drive and libido is associated with like health and longevity and good hormones and youthfulness. You don't have to be crazy like wild. I'm nothing like that, but I'm just alive and in that department, which is good. And your sexual energy is related to your expressive energy, like your sacral and root chakra, your sensual chakra, your orange, red, yellow chakras. It's got to do being grounded in the physical world and manifesting yourself and being expressive and creative anyway, like your relationships, being creative and expressive with your words, being creative and expressive with your art, your music, your relationships, your business, your sexuality, your clothes, your body language, anything, like just having energy to do stuff and to create and to be you as an individual. So all this has got to do with like having good adrenals and good hormones and basically good vitality. So that's why I always take Rejuvenate and Yin Jing herbs. They're my number one herbs that I recommend in the entire world. And I really also recommend Super Greens, as I said, and some of the other ones I already mentioned. So these days, like, loads of people are sick. And I work as a health coach, relationship coach, and life coach of body, mind, and spirit, okay? So I've learned the hard way through my own personal experience, and I've gotten out of the hole. So I've walked the path. I used to be depressed also, like, and obviously I was like sick and emotionally a mess. I've been depressed and sad and unhappy and lonely for like 2 decades of my life or more. 2.5 decades or something like 2 decades anyway. It's a long time. So I learned all this early in my life, and now I'm able to help people at a young age still, only 34. Obviously always learning, humbly learning always from everybody. I always make mistakes like everybody, and I gratefully learn and listen to people to help who help me. So that's what I do in life. I have that, and I have a herb shop. I have 2 books below, which are always interested in having a look at if they're below in the links. And yeah, befriend me on Facebook. I feel welcome to ask me any questions. I love and appreciate everybody who supports me and my family and my loved ones and my friends, just the way I'm trying to do with you now. I'm trying to help you, your loved ones, your family, and your friends. So anyone who supports me, I deeply appreciate. For example, like sharing the video. I love when people share the video or give us a like or comment or just try and connect with me and say hi or thank you. I love to help these people even more because they've connected and they're caring about